What is up, YouTube? Welcome or welcome back to my channel. We have not seen each other for a hot minute because I did take a little break, but I am back now. And today we're gonna do all day, full day of eating, only TikTok recipes. I mean, not really TikTok recipes, but recipes that I found on TikTok. And by the way, I did get a cat in the meantime, so that's new. That's Luna. She's super cute. But she is in a very mischievous mood right now, so I'm gonna let her go. I did try to teach her not to go on the counter, but it's just... I give up. It's just not working. But anyway, let's get into the recipes and I'll show you what I'm gonna make for breakfast. So the first recipe is from my all-time favorite TikTok chefs, like home chefs, home cooks. She's amazing, and this is just her recipe for kimchi fried eggs. I mean, I love her, so let's just watch it.
Hello. This is a photo of my eggs. And welcome to part one of what I'm going to be calling recreating photos from my Instagram stories. It'll be just food pictures. I feel like I need to clarify that. Now this recipe is kimchi eggs. It's really simple. Eggs, kimchi, olive oil, and my Made-In nonstick pan. I love Made-In. It's such a good investment. The nonstick doesn't wear off and it's completely non-toxic. And I know and recognize the beauty of a high heat, oil-drenched, stainless steel fried egg, but I like this method because you can use medium heat, cover it for 2 minutes, walk away, come back, and the whites will be set. So we have our photo. This is the exact same cooking method I used when I made the original photo. I didn't stage it this intensely then, but I'm trying very hard now. And personally, I like the mint. I think most people would like a Thai basil or a basil better, but I think we can all agree that the popping of the yolk is our favorite part.
Okay, so now I'm gonna show you my version of this. I immediately knew I have to make this because I love kimchi. Sometimes I just snack on kimchi. I've told people this and they always make fun of me because I snack on kimchi late at night. I just get that like kimchi craving, or in general like a fermented food craving. I'm Polish, that's why. And then I have some eggs that I need to use up, and I'm also defrosting some baguette. I have a lot of food in my freezer that I need to use up, so I'm just gonna do that instead of buying a whole new loaf of bread. Hence, it's gonna be a baguette. And yeah, it's not gonna be hard, so let's just get into it.
So I feel like this dish is just so self-explanatory that there's, again, nothing really to explain. So I just added some vegan butter and the kimchi, all of the kimchi I have left, but I kind of wish I had more. And then I just did one egg because I wasn't super hungry, added some salt on top. And just like in the TikTok, I don't know, I'm doing a voiceover again because we just saw how to make this. I am just gonna cover it up and wait for the whites to set. And then it's basically ready. And I just plated it with some baguette. And then I added the egg on top and the leftover kimchi from the pan and also some green onions. And that's basically it.
All right, so this is how I plated it. It's not as pretty because of the baguette and like, it's just not as pretty, but I think it looks good. It smells great. I mean, it smells like kimchi that is warm and an egg, but it smells great. So I'm just gonna go try that. And here, my cat again, you are not allowed to be here. Let's try this. I tried to do an aesthetic yolk popping, but it didn't work. It's not as liquid. And here's my cat again. It's a bit disappointing, but I can do better next time. I did try to take the perfect bite with some egg yolk, with some kimchi, with some green onions and baguette. And I don't know, I'm excited. All I have to say is that this is delicious and you should make this. And I will be making that again if I get more kimchi. But 10 out of 10, I love this creator. All of her recipes are so unique, but also, I mean, this is not very unique. A lot of people have done this before, but in general, all of her recipes are very unique and like just so good. It's like so up my alley. So if you like similar things, you should try this and you should also go follow her. But as of right now, I'm just gonna sit down, watch some YouTube videos and just eat it and enjoy it. And I will see you for lunch. If you've been on TikTok at all in the past 2 weeks, you already know what we're making for lunch. It's the viral tuna caddo sandwich. Now, as you know, I don't eat fish or meat, so I do have this... I do have some vegan tuna left over. I bought it at some point to try it and then I never did because I saw some reviews on TikTok that it wasn't that great, but I think now is the time to try it because I don't think it would have the same effect if I just did like a chickpea salad. I think it would be completely different, so I'm just gonna try this. But if everything goes wrong, if it's not good, then I also went all out with the bread and I made a no-knead focaccia that I already have in the oven right now. It should be done in around 5 minutes. And so I'm just gonna quickly whip up the tuna salad. I'm gonna do a tuna salad because The tuna mousse just looks like cat food to me. I just can't, like, it's just, it's throwing me off so much. And I also seen on TikTok that it's throwing other people off a lot as well. So I'm just gonna do a salad with some mayo and onion, I think. It's gonna mix that together and then we'll just assemble the sandwich. But before we go make the sandwich, let's just watch a TikTok video with the recipe. It's super simple. I don't think it actually needs a video, but just for the reference. Every day I spend hoping we never change, loving you, never wait or hesitate to tell me what is on your mind. Really do enjoy your company. I think you would agree, just where you'd rather be is right here with me. Make my day in every way. No, I'll be okay when you are around. Okay, the only thing that we're gonna do different is that we have focaccia instead of this bread, and we're not gonna toast it because I have fresh focaccia in the oven. I don't need to toast it. It's gonna be perfect and crispy on the outside as is. And I mean, yeah, that's the only difference. Never mind, I did toast it, but the whole sandwich in general was stupid simple to make, and now I have a delicious looking lunch. Let's see if it's gonna be delicious, but I am pretty excited. Although I am not sure like why the sandwich has such a hype, but maybe we'll see. So let's do a taste test together. Okay, one more. So I cannot taste the tuna at all. Which is good because I did try it from the can and I was not a fan. But all of the flavors go really well together and I really cannot taste it here. And I did take a big bite with like a lot of tuna, so maybe that is what the hype is about. Like you can really taste the pesto and the avocado and the tomato. Once again, you're not allowed to be here. But the tuna is just not really a flavor that is coming through, which might be, maybe that's why it's so trending, but I would assume that people like tuna that make the sandwich, so I don't know. Anyway, I will eat it gladly. Will I make it again? Not sure. I think I would maybe prefer to put something else in there, like chickpeas or some vegan chicken would be really good. But all in all, like the flavors all together combined, pretty good. You should try it. I'm hungry, I am tired, and I'm very excited for this meal. So we are gonna make something that is inspired by pasta alla vodka, like the Gigi Hadid pasta that we all ate over the last 2 years on repeat all the time, but so much better. I mean, I don't know if better, it's not supposed to replace it, it's just inspired by it, which is amazing. And it's basically beans alla vodka. I saw it on TikTok and I just knew I'm gonna have to make it because I love pasta alla vodka, I love beans, especially butter beans. Which mine, I mean, you can get them canned, but mine I actually had to cook from scratch because I couldn't find butter beans anywhere that are canned, but butter beans are just superior, so get that. Okay, let's just watch the recipe because you need to see this and you will understand why I need to make this immediately.
Quick and delicious meal to keep you cozy and warm during this winter season, look no further.
Beans alla vodka, just like penne alla vodka, but beans.
The best way I can describe this dish is that it feels like a hug in a bowl. It's comforting, it's creamy, it's so filling, and the best part about it, it comes together in less than 20 minutes. I don't know about you, I usually don't trust recipes when they claim that they're so fast, but this one, I'm telling you, the ingredients are so simple. You probably already have them in your pantry. I don't know, I haven't been to your house, but the ingredients are so affordable. This recipe just shows you how you can make a lot with very little. Whatever you do, you want to make sure to take time to cook off that tomato paste. It makes such a difference if you get it nice and caramelized. It only takes 5 minutes of your life, but it's gonna be worth it. This sauce uses heavy cream, but if you're looking for a vegan alternative, coconut milk, 10 out of 10, will do the job. Just get the full fat stuff. It's much better. Next, another pantry staple, canned butter beans. They're big, they're buttery, they're juicy, they're just perfect for this sauce. And listen up, folks, don't get it twisted here. This dish is not trying to replace your pasta. It's not trying to be pasta. It's just a pasta-inspired bean dish.
Okay, I stand by it. This looks delicious. So yeah, I have my ingredients prepped, my cooked butter beans. And just as an FYI, if you're looking for a good non-dairy vegan alternative to heavy cream, this is the best one I ever had, I ever found. It's delicious, and also it's the 15% fat, not the 30. The 15 is just so much better. I don't know, it's the best thing I could ever, ever find, and it's delicious, and it's dairy-free, and it takes exactly like regular heavy cream. So, I mean, let's just not waste any more time. Let's make it. So look at this. I plated it with a little bit of some vegan butter and some parsley and some baguette because I feel like it would go really well, and it looks so good. I'm very excited to eat this, and I am just so hungry. I'm gonna dive right in. Sorry, no taste test, but I am absolutely sure it's gonna be good. So of course I forgot to film an outro yesterday after dinner, but that's completely fine because I'm gonna do it now. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I know that I did, because it really gave me a reason to try all of the recipes that I'm usually just saving on my phone, and it was really fun and I really liked it. And there are some things that I'm definitely gonna be recreating, kimchi eggs or like the butter beans. It's just so good to try new things and kind of venture out. So let me know if you liked it, because I would definitely be up to making more of these videos. And other than that, please let me know what other videos you would like to see me do, and I will gladly do them. So once again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you soon. Bye!